What's up everybody, Alex here, and today we're going to talk about emulators and adding them to Steam. Now a few of you have asked me to make a tutorial video on how I had a lot of my SNES, N64, PS1, PS2, Wii and Wii U games on my Steam library and how I was playing them. So we're going to show you guys how to do that today. We were going to use a program called ICE, but ICE is no longer in development. So we're going to move to a program called Steam ROM Manager. I'm going to put the link in the description below. So let's go ahead and get started. So we're going to open up Steam ROM Manager. You'll have the link, like I said, in the description below. And you're going to click on Get the Latest Release. So here you're going to scroll down on the GitHub page. And you're going to click to Steam ROM Manager Setup 2.2.19.exe. It is automatically going to download. And once it is complete, about a 67 megabit file. We're going to go ahead and install that. Click run. That's okay. And as that installs, we'll go ahead and have it up and running. We'll maximize this for you guys so you can take a look. Now here, it's going to seem a little bit daunting, but don't be scared. This really isn't very difficult. Just the UI is a little bit classic, I think is a good way of putting it. So it's all going to depend upon which sort of emulators and games you're going to want to do first. So me personally, let's do the SNES first, because that's always a nice thing. We're going to click on Configuration Presets. And you're going to see all these emulators that are here. Okay, Armstart, Atari, if it's RetroArch, Atari Lynx, DOS games, you know, MAME, 3DS, N64. You want to make sure that you match the preset with the type of emulator of what it's called. So we're using SNES 9X for SNES games. We're going to scroll down to SNES RetroArch SNES 9X and click that. A lot of this has already been pre-filled out for us, which is really nice. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to skip where it says glob. Don't worry about that. The configuration is right. And we're going to change the Steam category to Super Nintendo. Okay. This is what it's going to look like when you go to Steam. So in your category, like I have here, you see how I have multiplayer games, continuous games, completed games, and just games, and then VR. The category will show Super Nintendo on that side. So we'll go back. Perfect. Now, here's where you need to find the executable of your emulator like we talked about before. Mine is located on a different drive in a different folder than what you may have. So make sure you know your pathway first. You'll get a window like this. We're going to go where I have my emulators. We're going to go to SNES. We're going to click SNES 9X, and then we're going to find the EXE. That's there. Perfect. Now it wants to find the ROMs directory. Pretty simple. Nothing too crazy. So we're going to go back. We're going to find where I have all my ROMs. Double click, and you're going to see nothing in there because it just wants to know where the folder is of your ROMs. It doesn't want to find the ROMs. It wants to know where the folder is of all the ROMs that you have for that emulator. We're going to select the folder. And the final thing we're going to do is find the path to Steam itself. So we're going to go, usually it should be in your C drive, program files 86, Steam, double click, and we're going to select the Steam folder. Don't find anything else. Don't worry about anything else. Select the main Steam folder. And that's it. All the commands are listed here. We're good to go. We're going to click Save on the bottom left. So now over here on the left-hand side, you'll see Nintendo, SNES, RetroArch. What we're going to do now is we're going to test the parser. Okay? Click Test. And look at this. You've got all these Super Nintendo games listed. Right? You got all these here, which is fantastic. Okay, so now we're going to do, so we're going to click success. Test is completed. We're going to go back to parser. And then now what we're going to do is we're going to do PS1. Okay, now PS1 is a little bit different. I'm using EPSXE. And unfortunately, EPSXE does not have a preset for Steam ROM Manager. So we're going to do this manually. Okay, hopefully we'll do it right the first time. So the preset we're going to pick is generic. We're going to keep glob. Configuration title, we're just going to call it Sony PlayStation or PlayStation. Yeah, PlayStation. You know what? We'll call it PSX. Steam category. PlayStation. No worries. Path to the emulator. Browse. Go to where you keep the emulator for that. Go to where you keep the EXE for that emulator. PSX. EPSXE.exe. Path to the ROMs. Nice and easy. Perfect. Path to Steam directory. x86. Steam. Select folder. Now here, where it says users glob, okay? This is basically going to tell Steam ROM Manager what files to specifically look for. You're going to see $ title at .zip and then line.zip. So we're going to delete where it says .zip. And for me, what I've been using for a lot of my ROMs, okay, for PS1, they're .bins. .bin. So what we're going to do is we're going to type inside the parentheses .bin. Easy. The next line down is going to be command line arguments. This is what you're going to use for Steam itself. So we want to find the one for EPSXE. Here it is. We're going to copy that. And we're just going to paste that right in there. Simple. Okay. So this is going to tell Steam how to load the actual ROM. Okay. But we're also going to add something here. We're going to do full boot. You know what? Let's not do full boot just yet. We'll test it first. I want to make sure everything works fine the first time. And then we'll do a full boot later. We're going to save it. Okay, and we're going to test the parser. Testing PSX parser, test completed, nothing showed. So that's a problem. Something happened, right? Let's figure out what happened here. We'll go to preview, generate the app list. And right, we're seeing all the SNES games that we have, right? We're seeing all of them listed here, but we're not seeing the and here are the PS1 games. I'm sorry. There's Brave Prince and Musashi. There's Ark the Lad. There's Breath of Fire 3 and 4. There's Final Fantasy Origins and Tactics. Front Mission 3. Grandia. Legend of Dragoon. Lunar. So I don't know why they didn't show a lot of the information. Info. No. No. Oh, there we go. Success wasn't clicked. So when the bottom icons here, if they're clicked, they'll show. So we want to keep it clicked. So we'll scroll down here just to keep an eye out and see what happened. Super Mario, Super NES. And now here's the PlayStation. Perfect. That's awesome. It did it again. It's okay. It did it again. Let's clear the log. Let's go back to parsers. Now we'll do the PS2. I'm using PCSX2. So we'll name this PlayStation 2. Path to PCSX2. We'll find that in our hard drive. Oh, no, it's Diablo. Emulators. PS2. There it is. Path to the ROMs of PS2. Classic consoles, ROMs, PS2. Path to Steam. So we're going to do them all today in one clean shot. That way you guys have an idea of what it looks like. All this stuff here. We're going to hit save. We're going to test the parser. Look at this, Arc the Lad, Black, Breath of Fire, Dragon Quarter, Dark Cloud 2, Dark Cloud, Dawn of Mana, Dot Hack Part 1, Part 2. So that worked. Awesome. Let's clear that. Go back to Parser. We're going to do our N64. We're using Project 64. I'm going to name it Nintendo 64. We're going to find, again, nice and easy. It's nothing too crazy. Find your emulator. Project 64. Path to the ROMs of the N64. Path to Steam. See? It's not that bad. I promised. Didn't I tell you it was going to be good? I said it's not going to be that bad. Look at this. 1080 Snowboarding, Banjo-Kazooie, Banjo-Tooie, Blast Corps, Conker's Bad Fur Day, Extreme G. Perfect. Let's keep going. Since we're here, let's keep going. Let's do the GameCube. We're using Dolphin for the GameCube. Perfect. Now we'll just call it GameCube. Let's find Dolphin, okay? Dolphin is trickier because Dolphin runs multiple consoles. So we're going to find Dolphin, path to GameCube ROMs. Perfect. Path to Steam. Save. Test the parser. Baten Kaidos, Dead to Rights, Eternal Darkness, F-Zero, Crystal Chronicles, Geist, Gladius, Four Swords, Luigi's Mansion. You get the drill. But you know what? While we're here, let's keep going. Let's just keep going. So the next one we're going to have is the Wii. So we're going to use Dolphin for the Wii. Okay? Path to Dolphin. Nice and easy. See? People say, oh, PC gaming's hard. I don't know how to do anything. A little bit of Googling. A little bit of patience. You can do a lot, okay? You can do a lot, especially with Steam. You can do a lot. Save, test the parser. I only have Xenoblade Chronicles. Easy. Now that everything is there, okay, we've got all our emulators loaded up, the ones that I have for right now. We're gonna go to preview. We're gonna generate the app list again. So we're seeing everything here. Okay, now it's all done in order of what we saw in our files. This is not the way it's going to show up in Steam. It's going to show up in Steam in pure alphabetical correct order. But here it's going to show up in the way that we have it listed in our files on our hard drive. So now comes the fun part. We can pick and choose the icons that are going to show in big picture mode of Steam and in the grid. So ActRaiser 2, we can choose the icons, right? You can have it look like that, you can have it look like that, or like that. I like that. Breath of Fire 2. Let's see, that's a cool one. I like that one. Here's Breath of Fire. Right, you can pick and choose how you want it to look. That's cool. Now, Chrono Trigger Crimson Echoes, that is a fan-made ROM, so it does not have a picture. I have to upload my own for that. Here's Dracula X. There you go. Look at that. Captain Commando, Donkey Kong Country, Earthbound, F-Zero, FF2, FF3, Final Fight 2, Final Fight 3, Final Fight, Lufia, Live a Live, Mega Man X, 2, 3, Ogre Battle. Look at that. Secret of Mana, Star Fox. Look at those great old games that people sleep on. Here's Alundra on the PS1. And Alundra 2. I like Alundra, that one. Arc the Lad 2. Let's see if there's any other cool. I like that one. Arc the Lad 3. Now it's going to show each specific disc. You can pick and choose. Now the really interesting thing about the PS1 library is that it has multiple tracks with each game. So it will load all of those specific tracks. We're going to remove those in a minute, and I'll show you what that means. So here's Ark the Lad, Brave Prince of Musashi, I like that. Breath of Fire 3, that's a nice one. There's 4. Castlevania Symphony of the Night, Breath of Fire 4, Disc 2. I'm sorry, that is the bin. Here's Tactics, Origins, Chrono Cross, Front Mission. We could pick a better Grandia logo for that, I think. Ooh, I like that one. I don't know Ubisoft published that. Legend of Dragoon, that is a classic. We'll leave that there. I do like the second one more so. Legend of Mana, that is a great game for the PS1. Silver Star Story, don't worry about the multiples. We'll figure that out. We'll show you how that works. Right, Medieval 2, Parasite Eve 1. Look at that. You can even change it to verify different discs, right? So you can say disc 1 is white, disc 2 is black. And then you can do stuff like this. Parasite Eve 2, there you go. That's kind of cool. So we're just picking, right, everything here. Seekaden, we're doing that. Siphon Filter 2, Siphon Filter, Siphon Filter 3. Some games won't be able to have an icon. That's okay. You know, we'll find one, we'll Google one, we'll do all that good stuff. Here's Tenchu, Thousand Arms, Valkyrie Profile. Right? You got everything here. Vandal Hearts 2, Wild Arms 2, Wild Arms, Xenogears, which is an absolute masterpiece of a game. Ark the Lad, now we're getting into the PS2 stuff, Black, Dragon Quarter, Dark Cloud, Dawn of Mana, we'll change it to that, Church of Cerberus, I'm okay, see Dot Hack Infection, Mutation, Outbreak and Quarantine, they don't have icons, but you can even add your own. So I have them already downloaded here, and we can even take a look, and we can just find the one that we're looking for. Here's Infection. Look at that. Here's Mutation. Here's Outbreak. So if you don't like the ones that are listed here, you can find your own online and quarantine. And you can even add it. Front Mission 4, which I think that's pretty good. Grandia 3, because 2 is on PC. Here's Manhunt. Radiata Stories. CD1, CD2. Look at that. You can even change the disc. That's awesome. Code Veronica, Seekaden 3, I like that. Seekaden 4, Tactics, Seekaden 5, Logan Shadow, Omega Strain, Time Splitters 1 and 2, Tenchu Fatal Shadows, Tenchu Wrath of Heaven, Valkyrie Profile 2, Xenosaga. Here's Xenosaga 2, doesn't have an icon, but I have one here. Look at that. Nice, right? Xenosaga 2, Disc 2. Let's pick a different one. There we go. Xenosaga 3. I think I have a different one for that. There we go. 1080 Snowboarding. Banjo-Tooie has a bunch of different ones. Look at that. Blast Corps. I feel like the N64 ones have a little bit better. Here's Extreme G2. So I've already like pre-organized a lot of stuff here. Right? You may not have a lot of this pre-organized. That's okay. You know, it'll come to a point where you'll see it, right? Well, it's 2, not 1. There we go. F0X Glover. Gotta love the glove. Right? Jet Force Gemini. Kirby 64, Majora's Mask, Mario Kart Perfect Dark. There we go. Ogre Battle. Look at this. Look how cool this is. Adding everything you want, the classic No Mercy. Banten Kaitos, Yoshi's Story. Look at this great stuff people put together. How cool is this? Dead to Rights. There you go, I think I have a Dead to Rights one. On the GameCube. I think we have a better one. I think so, here it is. That's a way better one. There we go, Eternal Darkness. Gladius, Zelda 4 Swords, Crystal Chronicles. Look at that. That's cool, man. Metal Gear Solid, Disc 1, Disc 2. Twin Snakes. Metroid Prime Echoes, Metroid Prime, PNO3. So everything is here, right? Even Resident Evil 2, Resident Evil Nemesis, Beautiful Joe, Wave Race, Xenoblade Chronicles. That's nice. So after we've done all that, we're going to click Save App List. Done adding and removing entries. If Steam is open, exit Steam. Okay? Once Steam has been exited, relaunch Steam. And if all goes well, I'll take a look and we'll see. Here's my Steam account. We're going to go to my library. Look at that. Close the chat. Here's 1080. Here's ActRaiser. Here's Alundra. Amnesia. Ark the Lad. All nice and organized. And everything, even in the Steam library, we can always set a custom image if we missed one. That's not a big deal. We can always add it, okay? That's the really nice thing. Which one are we looking for? Baten Kaitos? Origins, right? There's one. Right click, set custom image. There's two. And look at that. And now, for the ultimate test. Let's go to our grid. We can see, let me move myself. We can see all the games that we have here for the GameCube, right? Nintendo 64, PlayStation. Look at that. So you see where it says tracks, right? We can delete where it says track. That's not going to launch the game. So we can delete those shortcuts. That's okay. Right? PS2. Super Nintendo. Let's do a Super Nintendo game. Let's do Earthbound. And here's Earthbound. Up and running on your PC through a shortcut on Steam. Let's try another Dolphin game just to see what happens. You know what? Let's do Dot Hack Mutation. PS2. Oh, I gotta set this up here. Make sure you set up your emulators first, kids. Let's try Parasite Eve. Hopefully I don't have to set anything up. There you go. Here's Parasite Eve. Now, of course, you have to do some manual adjustments to your emulators on their own. But in the grand scheme of things, once the emulator is set, you're good to go. You won't ever have to worry about anything. And there's Parasite Eve being played on my PC through a shortcut on Steam. Cool thing about this, too, is that you can even launch this in big picture mode, and everything you need is going to be right there on the big screen, which is even cooler, if you ask me. Now, I know what you're all going to be asking. N64, right? 1080 snowboarding. Will it run? There it is. 1080 snowboarding. Live. With the Steam overlay in your game, which is even better because now you can shift tab. Well, you should be able to shift tab. I didn't set the, there we go. There's shift tab over my N64. It's 1080. So like I said, you can shift tab, put it over it, get everything set up. Let's try Dolphin one more time. See if that gives me an error. Remind me later. So it looks like it's something with the Wii that I have to change, but that's okay. And there you go. Zelda Four Swords running with an emulator over Steam. I gotta set a memory card. No wonder things are acting up. But make sure things are working first before you start adding things to your Steam library. And you're good to go. You can grab anything that you want and play any game that you want from Steam. Hope you guys enjoyed the video and the tutorial. See you guys next time and have a great one.